guys. So for this tutorial, I'm going to start off with my Coastal Scents Step 1 Eye Primer. I'm going to be applying it all over my eyelid, blending it up from my lash line up to my brow bone and applying to my lower lash. Then I am taking Veil from my Borghese Palette, and I'm going to be applying that with a fluffy brush as my transition shade. Next, I'll be taking ColourPop's Color in Desert. With my finger, I will be blending that along with my transition shade and partially in my crease and blending it on. Then, also applying with my finger, I'll be taking ColourPop's shade in Drift, which is a gorgeous shade, and I will be applying that to my eyelid, blending it up towards my crease and building the color up as I want it to be. I'm also going to take a synthetic brush and just kind of blend out the color that was placed in my crease to soften it up. Then I'm taking the Laura Geller Caviar Eyes Pencil in Plum, and I'm going to be running that on my lower lash line to help with a smoky pop of color. That will be my base for the colors I'm placing there. Next, taking ColourPop's Matte Eyeshadow, and this is in the color Doe a Deer. I'm going to be applying that with my MAC 217 brush to the outer corner of my eye, blending it out on the outer V, sweeping it and blending it into the crease, and get that color built up to the consistency and the shade that I want. Just blending it out so there are no harsh lines as well. And I'm also going to apply that to my lower lash line, which you'll be seeing here in a sec. And I'm going to be applying it to the 2/3 of my lower lash line with the same brush. And then with a little bit more precision, I'm going to go in there and just build that color to work it into my outer V and crease, and then go in with my finger to kind of smooth out any harsh lines and blend it out. Once that's done, I'm going back in with that burgundy shade again. With my MAC 217, I will be sweeping that color on the inner corner and inner third of my lower lash line. Then I'm taking Basque from my Borghese palette, and I'm going to be using that as my highlight color, blending it out with a fluffy brush and applying it to my brow bone. Once that's done, I'm taking this gorgeous shade. It is called Partridge, also from ColourPop. And I'm going to be applying that with a brush. I am using, again, my MAC brush, and I'm sweeping that color into my crease, making sure that it is blending together in my crease with the purple and the burgundy shade. It's also going to provide a nice pop of color right there. And since this shade is a dual chrome, it'll really take on different hues after it's applied and blended. Then going with my finger once again, I'm just going to kind of blend it out so there are no harsh lines. Then taking Desert once again, with my finger, I'm just going to go in and blend it out again up towards my transitional area. Now I'm taking ColourPop's Girly, which is a gorgeous white shadow with a gold shift. This will be a golden pink shift, so it'll really pull up that pink burgundy hue from the lid shade, but also apply a nice pop of color and brightness. Using my Jordana 12-Hour Made to Last eyeliner pencil in Black Point, I'm applying it to my tight line and waterline. And then once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and take my NYC liquid liner, which is something I use very often, and I'm going to be creating my wing. I get asked all the time, how come one wing always seems a little bit different than the other? It's because I have a skin tag on this eye that I'm applying it here. So I have to really either go above it or below it, and sometimes it can kind of distort the way it looks. But I'm basically applying a pretty dramatic wing and taking that eyeliner all the way to the inner corner of my eye, connecting it out. Now I'm taking this NYX pencil and I will put the name of the color on my blog, but because I can't remember what it's called, but it's like a purpley pink shade, and I am using it to line my lips. Then I'm going ahead and taking ColourPop's lippy sticks in the color Leather, which is a gorgeous deep purple. So pretty. I'm totally crushing on this lipstick right now. It is a matte shade, so if you wanted something more glossy, you could definitely top it off with a gloss, but it is very matte, and I'm applying that to my lips. Then I'm going ahead in my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blush Palette with my e.l.f. Small Stippling Brush, and just applying that blush to my cheeks, blending it up and blending it in, so I just have a soft flush of color. Then taking Radiant Light from my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Palette, and I'm just sweeping that on the upper part of my cheekbones on both sides, just to kind of give a little highlight there. I'll also be applying it to my forehead, down the bridge of my nose, my Cupid's bow, and on my chin for a little bit of golden highlight. And that is the look, guys. I hope you enjoyed this kind of fall slash Thanksgiving slash Winterberry inspired look using majority ColourPop cosmetics. Definitely check them out, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Have a great one and happy Thanksgiving. Bye.
Are you listening?